More now on just what that means for the rest of the world. Those origins in Greece have really become global debt concerns. And joining us now to tell us what he thinks is the goal of the meeting underway in Washington today and tomorrow between Greek leadership and U.S. leadership is now Gary Jenkins. He's head of credit research at Evolution Securities. Good afternoon to you, Gary. I know you're in London there. Hello. Tell me, why is the Greek Prime Minister today speaking in Washington, tomorrow meeting with President Obama, if he's trying to rally investors to support Greece here, to give him a sort of a vote of confidence? Why go to Washington and not Wall Street?
Well, first of all, for any European politician, it's great to share a stage with President Obama. That still gives you some kind of credibility in Europe. And it gives him a global platform on which to talk about Greece, to talk about the cuts they're trying to make to the budget deficit, the improvements they're trying to make to the economy. And from their point of view there, hopefully that will actually resonate around the world and persuade investors to continue funding them.
Because as you might have heard at the beginning of this show, we were speaking with one of our reporters down in Washington, and he reminded us that the IMF headquarters are located in Washington, that perhaps there may be a gesture there towards some interest in working with the IMF. Are we reading too much into it, or are you keeping sort of one eye on those scheduled visits that Papandreou is making when he's in this country?
Well, I'm sure that one of the reasons that he would like to be near the IMF is that it puts a bit more pressure on Europe to actually try and come to some kind of solution if he needs it. The last thing that Europe wants is the IMF stepping into a Eurozone sovereign and sorting out their problems. So I think from his point of view, it's a good strategic move to be near the IMF.
Mm-hmm. Well, it seems like the markets are breathing a bit of a sign of relief given the conversation had over the weekend with French President Sarkozy that suggested that, pretty much not even suggested, flat out said that the Eurozone would come to the aid of Greece here. So why are we still talking about it? Is the lid sealed on the solution here?
No, I don't think so. I think Sarkozy spoke a very good game. He spoke very positively. He said exactly what they needed to say, because at the end of the day, the European Union does not want to fund Greece directly. They want the markets to do that for them. But the best way of persuading investors to do that is to set the scene that you are prepared to be the lender of last resort if necessary, so therefore you're investing with the EU rather than against them. And I think really that's the undertone of Sarkozy's message. And indeed, what we've been hearing from European politicians is very much don't bet against us. So I think that what Sarkozy said was the right thing to say to try and persuade investors to actually back Greece and buy their debt.
So are we going to see a parade, though, of other European leaders with their own fiscal issues coming to the White House? I mean, we do know the Irish Prime Minister will be here as usually scheduled for St. Patrick's Day, but now there are concerns from Moody's, particularly about Portugal. We're also hearing about spillover to Bulgaria, Fitch Ratings and Capital Economics raising concerns that there could be contagion there. I mean, are we just seeing sort of the first domino fall here?
Well, possibly that could be the case. It really depends upon whether the market's prepared to fund Greece. If Greece actually can get out of this dilemma and can sell their debt, then I think, as we've seen today, everything calms down, because if Greece can survive, then so can everyone else. However, clearly, if we have a situation where the market is not prepared to buy Greek bonds and the EU has to either step in or walk away, then the contagion impacts and the unintended consequences of that could be quite huge.
Do you think that we will hear anything during any kind of question and answer period with the Greek Prime Minister about the role of U.S. financial institutions in helping to sell products to Greece to perhaps mask their debt?
I think so. I think that's obviously been a hot topic conversation. But to be perfectly honest, I think in Europe, for once, we're not really blaming the Americans. I think what's happened in Europe is that the politicians are actually blaming one product, which is credit default swaps.
All right. We'll be listening in there. Thank you so much, Gary.